If your smartphone can run the games like Call of Duty, PUBG, then why not switches, routers, and firewalls? Today, we are going to demonstrate how your smartphone can be used for study and practice CCNA and NP labs. Someone asked me the question in the study group that how we can practice the labs. I read through the comments and I noticed that most of the people are not aware that it can be done. There is a lot of possibilities. I have four more hacks for you, which I have learned while I was studying for last 10 plus years, which I will be sharing in the upcoming videos. Those who don't know me, my name is Vikas and I will be covering CCNA, NP and IE. Please hit like and subscribe and hit the notification icon so you can view the upcoming videos. Let's get started. What are the things you need for running these mobile labs? One is you need to download the packet tracer on iOS or mobile from the Google Play Store or Apple App Store. The second is you can have an external keyboard. It will help you to type faster. It could be wired or Bluetooth. I have tested both. It works perfectly. The third thing you need is a video series. You can watch the videos and you can have the PDF study guide. You can even have the external screen as well to make the screen bigger if you want. Let's quickly demonstrate it, how we can do that. Once the packet tracer start, you will be needing a sign-in. You can create a free account on Netcad. I have copied the link where you can create a new account, or even you can log in it as a guest's account. I have already logged in. Once it launches, you just click on the new. You can see this is your workspace. Here you can tap it and you will see all the routers, switches, computers, what you can place on this environment. All right, just click switches. Let's place 13650. Let's place another one, 3650 on this one. All right, and we have to connect these both. Let's click on any of the device. It will pop up with their connections. Select connect. And then you need to select the device where you want to do that. Let's select it. All right, now we have to choose the cable between them. Let's choose a straight through cable. I want to connect it to Giga Ethernet 0/1, Giga Ethernet 0/1 on switch 0. Alright, click the workplace icon, which is basically you can see this one on the screen. Now if you see the switches are connected, it's booting up, and let's go to the CLI. And now you can notice that the switch is properly booted and everything what you can do it on the laptop, now you can do it on the mobile. So here I'm using an external keyboard. If you press enter, you can see it's going down, right? So with this keyboard, now you can type anything. I have both of my keyboards. One is the wired and the other one also I have it with me. It's both are working. So let's say enable, configure terminal, right? And it's working fine. Let's do show IP interface brief. And we can see all the interfaces. We can see Giga Ethernet 0/1 is up. Let's go to configure terminal and let's do something. Let's assign a VLAN 100, name it data VLAN, and let's go to interface Giga Ethernet 0/1. And we can make switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 100. Let's go to interface VLAN 100. Let's assign it an IP address 192.168.1.1 since it's switch 1. Let's assign a subnet mask, exit, and we can change the host name. Let's make it switch 1. Okay, let's go and see show IP interface brief. We should see an IP address on VLAN 100. It's perfect. You can go to the other switch, go to the CLI, and we can go to configure terminal, change the host name to switch 2, make it a VLAN 100 here as well, name it data VLAN. Okay, and we can go to interface Giga Ethernet 0/1. Let's switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 100. and we can assign an IP address to VLAN 100 as space VLAN 100 IP address 192.168.1.2. The other one is 1.1. Let's assign it 1.2. And we can exit. Let's end. Show VLAN. And we can see there is a data VLAN and gigaethernet/1 interface is there. Ping 192.168.1.1. And we should get a reply. So few packets are getting dropped. It's okay because when it's starting the communication, it needs to resolve the ARP. And now if we re-ping it, it's working perfect. You can basically run all the commands, but she was able to do it in the laptop. Let's do some more tests. What are the things other than this one you can do? Let's click on the switch and find out. There is a way to simulate it as well. When you was using the packet tracer on your laptops, you can do a real-time environment or simulation. We will try to do the simulation as well here. Let's click it and change the mode from real time to simulation. And let's put a packet on the switch. Click on the switch. Okay, you have a packet. And let's play it. Now, if you notice, it should be doing the same thing what you was able to do it on normal packet tracer. The packet is probably transferring, which is perfectly fine. It's reaching, the reply came. We can even read the packet as well, what was happening inside the packet. Let's try to do that. Just click on any of the packet and you should be able to see all the things, what it can do and everything, what is the headers and what is moving between these frames. We can even read more details as well by just clicking PDU out. And we should be able to see what are the more details of that packet. Try to learn as much as possible without spending money and access from anywhere. Hope you got the idea how it can be done. I do suggest use the external keyboard. It makes typing easier. And if you face any difficulties, send me a message. Hopefully I will be able to help. If I have increased your knowledge in any ways, please don't forget to subscribe. I will see you in the next lecture. Take care.